pretty shocking report this morning on what looks to be the lessons not learned from Benghazi. It's a scathing report that comes from the State Department itself. Their watchdog has gone over it and decided that almost nothing has been done to boost our security levels at our other high-risk outposts out there. So our diplomats right now are no safer today than they were when four Americans were killed in Benghazi that night. Steve Hayes joins me now, senior writer for the Weekly Standard and Fox News contributor, and Rick Grinnell, former spokesman for four of the last five UN ambassadors. Rick and Steve, great to have you both with us this morning. Thank you so much. You know, let's dig in here with Hillary Clinton first, because I remember Hillary Clinton saying, you know, look, don't worry, because we looked at the accountability, the ARB, the account review board, thank you, and we're going to implement all of their recommendations, every single one, Steve.
Yeah, I think what this latest in IG report points to is the fact that the administration has looked at Benghazi as largely a PR problem rather than a substance problem. If you go back to the very beginning in the administration's handling of the Benghazi affair, they tried to suggest to the American people that the real issue here was the security issue and was the attacks themselves. And so when the ARB report came out making all of these recommendations, the administration immediately, without hesitation, said, we are implementing all of these recommendations, we are doing it. And the press sort of took them at their word. Now we come to find out through this general report that they're not actually implementing any of the recommendations, or many of the recommendations, to the extent that they said that they would.
Yeah, I mean, Rick, it really fortifies the notion that their take on this is just as Steve has put it. You know, just keep, you know, walk by, and as Hillary Clinton said, what difference does it make why it happened? So they seem to have the perspective that it's a dangerous world, stuff happens out there, it's obviously sad and regrettable, but that nobody was to blame.
Yeah, look, the State Department has spent the last year attacking Republicans for making this political, and yet they haven't implemented any of the recommendations. And I think this is also a very serious indictment and a warning sign for Congress. The Senate Foreign Relations Committee has made this issue a political issue. Senators Menendez and Durbin and Boxer have ridiculed the Benghazi people who have been focused on Benghazi. And I think that Fox News should get some kudos here, because they've stayed on this issue. Adam Housley has been very good about highlighting the problems with security. And now we're finding out that Pat Kennedy and Tom Nides and Hillary Clinton, all of these individuals at the State Department, have not been implementing the recommendations. And Congress has not been doing a very good job of oversight here. We need to have hearings. They need to stay on these issues so that the recommendations are actually implemented.
Yeah, I mean, there were, you know, there's a paper trail here, Steve, of requests for more security at that outpost and in Libya. So when you go back and look at this, wouldn't it just sort of help them to move along, which seems to be what they want to do, if they could have had the Inspector General look at their report and say, yep, you know what, they've taken new measures, security is better, you don't have to worry if your family members work at one of our outposts because we've stepped it up.
Right. Look, even if you take the most charitable view for the administration, which was, in effect, these security reports never reached somebody like Secretary Clinton, never reached officials who were in a position to really make the kinds of changes that would have prevented what happened on the ground in Benghazi that night. Even if you believe that view, which was one of their original arguments, you have to now say, well, what are you doing to change it? I mean, are you making these kinds of structural changes that would prevent this, that would allow the kinds of requests that we saw coming up from the ground in Benghazi to reach the people who are in a position to actually implement security changes to keep the people on the ground safe? And the answer, plainly, from this IG report is no.
Yeah. I mean, Rick, if you're talking to family members or diplomats themselves who are in some of these high-risk areas, and one of the most shocking things about this whole situation was that Benghazi and Libya were treated like they were pretty much every other place. You know, they talk about, you know, budget considerations and reasons to pull security back and to replace them with local guards. I mean, you know, I wouldn't want one of those jobs, and I wouldn't want one of my family members in one of those jobs at this point.
Yeah, exactly. And if you're in an overseas post that's high risk, that's a dangerous post as labeled by the State Department, you've got to look at this report and be very concerned that the security measures that were promised have not been implemented. This is a dangerous warning sign. It's also a warning sign to the media that have been dismissive. And, you know, I'm not sure what MSNBC is going to have to do with this report. They're going to have to explain what Benghazi is to their viewers.
Mm. Well, they did sort of jump on board when Greg Hicks started talking. It suddenly became a story for everybody. I mean, so what happens now? So you get an inspector general report, Steve, and does that get, you know, swept under the rug as well? Or can people expect that something will happen?
Well, I would expect that the fact that they haven't implemented these changes would get some attention. There was another part of the Inspector General report that I disagree with, where they said, in effect, the Accountability Review Board actually had done its job in an independent and unbiased way, when the facts, I think, especially from the hearing and the transcribed interviews over the past couple weeks, point strongly in the other direction. But I think what happens next is we start to hear from the survivors. I think that'll first take place behind closed doors in congressional committees, and then ultimately we'll start hearing from them in public. There's going to be a book that's out from somebody who was on the ground in Libya, not in Benghazi, in October. There's another book coming out beginning of next year by three survivors who were actually on the ground in Benghazi. These are stories that are going to come out, and I think we'll get answers to a lot of the questions don't have answers to right now.
Great point. I mean, we talk about the ARB and a lot of questions about their credibility and why they didn't talk to Hillary Clinton as part of that report, and it sure looks like it's being swept under the rug. That could bring it right back. Steve, thanks so much. Rick, thank you.